welcome to our study tonight, Monday, April 13. Let's bow our heads. Our Father in heaven, tonight we invite your Spirit to enlighten our thoughts, to give us understanding, that we may see clearly the teachings of Jesus about the law, and help us that by your grace we may keep it for the good of ourselves and for your kingdom, Lord. I pray in Jesus' name, amen. Jesus and the law. Our study tonight is focused on Matthew 5:17 to 20, Matthew 22:29, Matthew 23:2-3. Okay, and there are other texts there. I will provide you so many texts tonight that will substantiate the claims of Jesus found in the first text. Think not that I am come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill. You see, the law refers to here is the Ten Commandments, the moral law, which were in the Old Testament. This topic is a controversial topic, especially among many Christians and Protestants, because many of them are teaching, advocating that there is no more law, there is no more Ten Commandments because it belongs to the Old Testament, it's obsolete, and besides, it's difficult. Those are the issues they raise against the law. The New Testament law is very easy, it's love. Let's see, and let's allow the Bible to interpret itself. That's the principle we are applying here. We allow verses to speak for itself, we compare it, and then we make conclusion. I provided you here tables, okay? Column 1, I put there all the commandments, the Ten Commandments actually found in Exodus 20:3-17. The red block there, columns, actually New Testament law, but the New Testament law there actually refers only to the Gospels. We do not include here the Acts in the Apostles in the Book of Revelation. We focus only on the direct teachings of Jesus, statements that came out of the mouth of Christ, and that is from the Gospel. Acts of the Apostles, we will take them separately. So we will prove here in this study tonight that the Old and the New Testament do not contradict each other. In fact, we are saying that the Bible of Jesus Christ was not the New Testament because that was not in existence at the time of Christ. The Bible of Christ was the Old Testament. Therefore, the textbook of Christ in his teaching was not the New Testament, but the Old Testament. And we will look into this text. Okay, so number one there in the Ten Commandments, thou shalt have no other gods. Now, for purposes of PowerPoint, we shorten it so that it will be clearer there. But the reference, the full text are all found there. So, in the first commandment, the Bible says, thou shalt have no other gods. Exodus 20 verse 3. Jesus teaches, he did not come to destroy the law. That is contrary to the advocacies of many Christians that did away with the law. No, he did not come to destroy but to fulfill it. Okay? And in Mark 12:28-32, Matthew 22:37-40, Luke 10:27, Jesus teaches, he taught directly his people, there is only one Lord and one God. That's equivalent to there is no other God because there is only one God. You see? So, the principle there actually includes the green column there, the third column, principles of the law, so that you will easily remember what's the principle here that does not change or do not change, because principles don't change. Okay, so no other gods. Jesus said there is only one God, and that principle is loyalty. Jesus demonstrated that. Number two, thou shalt have no graven images. Okay, Exodus 20:4-6, Jesus said worship him only, in other words, nothing in between. Matthew 4:10, and in John 4:23-24, you worship God in spirit and in truth, nothing in between. That's how God defined how to worship him. See, so the principle there is worship. Number three in the Ten Commandments, okay, thou shalt not use the name of the Lord thy God in vain. Okay, so in the teachings of Jesus in Matthew 6:9, Luke 11:2, John 17:26, he included that in the model prayer. You remember the disciples came to Jesus Christ and said, teach us to pray. That's the model he taught his disciples. He included their hallowed be thy name. See, pack your name, something like that. So Jesus did not contradict the teachings of the Old Testament because that was his textbook, contrary to the claims of many Christians today, respecting the name of God. The principle is reverence. I will not expound this because our purpose is only to show that the Old Testament and the New Testaments are not contradictory to each other. Jesus did not do away the Old Commandment in the New Testament. They are the same. Number four there is, keep the Sabbath holy. Okay, and Jesus said in Mark 2:27 and then Luke Luke 4:16, the Sabbath was made for man. That's the statement of Jesus. And there are so many texts there, okay, about Jesus keeping the Sabbath. Of course, the way Jesus kept the Sabbath was different from the Jewish rulers keep the Sabbath. Jesus taught in the New Testament that the way and the right way of keeping the Sabbath should be doing good for men. It is not against the law to do good on the Sabbath day. That's why Jesus healed many sick persons on Sabbath day or Sabbath healing episodes. Well, many Christians interpret that as Jesus was trampling down the law, doing away with the Sabbath. No, Jesus was teaching them this is the proper way of keeping the Sabbath. The Sabbath should be a blessing to people by storing their health and feeding them, doing good for all men on Sabbath day. The principle there is holiness set aside. The Lord has set aside a day, one of the 7 days, I mean the creation week, and He set it aside for worship and for doing good. So this is what Jesus said, love your God, the first and the greatest of the 10 commandments. Okay, He was asked which one is the greatest, and this was His answer, Matthew 22:37-38. Loving God is our number one value, and that is the number one principle that we subscribe to. The high ranking principle is God. Any law that would contradict that, we subscribe to the highest value, God. Second to that is our life. Our life is the second highest value there. And so we will go to the second group of commandments that Jesus said, like the first one, the second greatest of the commandment is loving our fellow men. Loving our fellow men begins at home. Exodus 20:12, honor thy father and thy mother. And you take note that in Mark 10:19, Luke 18:20, Mark 7:10, Jesus directly quoted the commandment, honor thy father and thy mother. The 10 commandments were quoted word for word by Jesus Christ. Honor thy father, thy mother. The principle in the 5th commandment is respecting authorities. Of course, the first authority in our lives are the parents. But that is a generic term which refers to anybody who has authority, we need to pay respect. Okay, traffic enforcers are persons in authority. The government who implements quarantine law, we need to respect them. That's how we love our fellow men. Starts at home. Number 6, thou shalt not kill, Exodus 20:13. In the New Testament, okay, Matthew 5:22, Mark 10:19, Luke 18:20, direct quotations of Jesus Christ, thou shalt not kill. And if you read that one, you will find out that Jesus explained, magnified, elaborated this commandment. And Jesus said, if you are angry with your brother without a cause, if you call him raka, in Tagalog, gago, okay, say bad words to your fellow men, you are not loving them. You are not preserving their life, actually. You see, the general principle there is preserve life. That's why we follow the government's law on quarantine, because the law on quarantine is actually preserving life. The government does not want us to die, does not want us to be contaminated with a deadly disease. So we follow that. Why? It's in accordance with the law of God. Number 7, thou shalt not commit adultery. Exodus 20:14. And in Matthew 5:27-28, and then Mark 10:19, Jesus directly quoted the 7th commandment, thou shalt not commit adultery. And Jesus explained it very well. And Jesus said, you have heard it was said long time ago, thou shalt not commit adultery. But I tell you that if you look at a woman with lust in your heart, you already committed adultery here. So here, the teachings of Jesus is clearly different from the teachings of the rabbis. Jesus actually teaches in the New Testament that sin begins not in the axe, not in the bed, but sin begins here, because that violates the principle of purity. And the number 8, thou shalt not steal, Exodus 20:10. And Jesus quoted the same law, thou shalt not steal, Matthew 5:19-20, 19:17-19, Mark 7:10, and then Luke 18:20. Take note of that. Those are the texts that Jesus used in the New Testament, that He taught in the New Testament directly from the 10 commandments. So Jesus was supporting His earlier statement that He did not come to destroy it, but He came to support and to magnify the law. The principle there is respecting properties. Do not steal the property of other people. Intellectual property, whatever property is that. Number 9, thou shalt not bear false witness. Exodus 20:16. Okay, and Jesus quoted that directly. Not bear false witness. Mark 10:19, Matthew 5:37, and then Luke Luke 18:20. The principle in the ninth commandment is truthfulness. God wants His people to be truthful by not telling a lie. So when we are accustomed to saying the truth, nothing but the truth, then we become truthful Christians. Those are principles which will never change. And in number 10, thou shalt not covet. Okay? Jesus in Luke 12:15, Matthew 16:26, and then Mark 4:19. Jesus said, beware of covetousness. Directation from the law. Covetousness. The principle there is contentment. You see, the problem of covetousness is we look at the things which are outside of our own property. We look at things which are from our neighbors there. You see, the secret there is to look at our own things, and Jesus said, don't worry about these things. God will give you all these things, but with the condition, seek first His kingdom and His righteousness, and all those things that you covet, God will give it to you. Contentment, you see. So these are the direct quotations of Jesus Christ from the Old Testament, which are recorded in the New Testament, or only limited to the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. But there are so many texts, the apostles quoted the Ten Commandments. What we are saying to prove here is that it is not true that the Old Testament commandment is obsolete in that in the New Testament it's not there. No, it's all there, you see. So, to reflect on that, let me use the statement of Christ found in Matthew 19:17. It says, if you want to enter life, keep the commandments. You see that? Jesus equated eternal life with keeping the commandments. Of course, after we are forgiven, after we are saved, if you want to enter life, in another statement, Jesus said, if you love me, then keep the commandments. In other words, Jesus was teaching that the motivation for keeping the commandments is not for salvation, but because we love Him. And that is, commandments of God would lead to eternal life. Let's go into further reflections. I put it this way in a question, which of the 10 commandments do I keep? I want you to be honest with yourself. You are not graded here. You are grading and evaluating yourself. Check there. Do you love God by having no other gods? Are you sure you have no other gods? Are you sure money, properties are not your gods? Only God who made the heavens and the earth. Number 2, okay, no images in worship. Are you sure there are no idols there? No graven image of Saint Peter, of Jesus Christ, of Mama Mary there? It just there in the Ten Commandments. Check that. That is the commandments that you keep. And then number 3, no using His name in vain, reverend. Okay? You don't use His name, Christ's name, God's name, ordinarily. And then number 4, are you keeping the 7-day Sabbath? Which one of these do you keep? And then the second portion there that Jesus taught, second greatest commandment is love man. Honoring parents. Are you respecting your parents? Are you respecting traffic authorities, law enforcement on the COVID-19? Okay? Are you preserving life by staying home, avoiding to be contaminated? Are you not practicing abortion, that's killing? Are you practicing purity? Is your life pure? You don't commit adultery? Number 8, no stealing. You respect property of others? And number 9, are you truthful with everything you say that comes out of your mouth? Okay. Jesus, through John the Revelator, saw the people who have entered heaven in Revelation as are those who are keeping the commandments. There's no lie in there. And number 10, no coveting. Are you contented with the life the Lord has given you here? Okay, so check which one. If you check all the 10, praise the Lord, okay? But if there are 2 there or 1 that you did not check, then you need processing. Why are you not keeping that? What prevents you from following the 10 commandments? You need processing. You need more time to reflect on why are you not following. And James is telling us, if you offend one, it's equivalent to offending all or not following all. So you see the seriousness and the importance of the teachings of Jesus about the law. It's not true that there is no Ten Commandments in the New Testament. We have just surveyed, it's all there in the teachings of Jesus. Okay, the apostles have different references there, we did not go. But I hope and I pray, because I know you want to enter life, Jesus said, then keep the commandments. Father in heaven, thank you for the enlightenment today. May your spirit be in our hearts and minds to transform us, that by love that would motivate us, we will keep the commandments because they are easy, because it is your grace who would enable us to keep this one. May you bless our brethren who are studying the Bibles tonight as they review those texts, help them that they may come up to the right conclusion that Jesus did not come to destroy the law, but He fulfilled. Therefore, we have the victory of overcoming sin, following it through the victory of Christ. Because I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Lift up the-
trumpet and loud let it ring.